In this video, I explain contamination of hydraulic fluids. First, I explain the definitions of contamination, then effect of contamination, then after causes of contamination means due to which reasons the contamination is created in the hydraulic fluids, then after remedies of contamination. So first I explain the definitions. Contamination means mixing of unwanted impurities in hydraulic oils, means in a oil some unwanted particles or unwanted impurities are come in a hydraulic oil, it is called as the contaminations. Now from which places the contamination is coming inside the hydraulic oils? So impurities may be dust, dirt, muds, chips, plastic, fiber, sand and the moisture. Okay, so dust is present in atmosphere. Okay, so dust is come into the oil if there is a leakage. That is a dirt also possible. Birds means that is a small particle is removed due to the wear and tear of the component, then chip, plastic, fiber, sand and moisture. So due to this component are added in a hydraulic oils, it is called as the contaminations. Now effect of contamination on a hydraulic oils. First is the oxidation of oil, due to which oil become acidic, which in turn cause the corrosions of metallic parts. Okay. So due to these unwanted impurities, the oxidation of the oil is start, means they are start to react with the oxygen. Okay, and it is converted into the acidic, and due to the acidic of the hydraulic oils, they are corrode the metallic parts of the hydraulic systems. Second one is the formation of gel and varnish, which will stick to the internal surface of the component, hence the moving component cannot move easily. Okay, so due to the gel and varnish, the motion is the stick and they are not freely rotated, and jams and jerk will be caused in a motion. So motion is jam or either a jerk is fails. Okay, and this gel and varnish may also block the passage of oil flow, so oil is not supplied to the full system and system is stopped. Next one is increased wear and tear. So due to the contaminations, the wear and tear is increased in a hydraulic systems, and which in turn causes the surface roughness. Due to the wear and tear, the surface roughness of the component is increased, due to which friction is increased, and due to the friction is increased, the temperature of the oil is increased and disturb the performance of the system. So due to wear and tear, roughness is increased, due to roughness friction is increased and the temperature is also increased, and it disturbs the performance of the systems. So due to this friction, okay, temperature is increased. Temperature increase means heat is more generated due to the frictions, and due to this high temperature, the rate of oxidation of oil is increased drastically, and oil property will be severely affected. Oil and will be spoiled in very less times, means oil life is reduced and we need to change the oil in a very short times. Okay, due to the spoiling of the life of the oil in very short times. So these are the various effect due to the contaminations. Now next we study what are the reasons due to which the contamination is created. Before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to the oil hydraulics and pneumatics, as well as the another subject of the mechanical engineering. For the more video, I request to visit the playlist, and for the OHP, the various link is provided in a card, means on a top right screen of your mobile, there is a I symbol is there. Now next one is causes of contaminations and remedies. So impurities get into the hydraulic oils from the different source, some of which are as follow. So proper care should be taken to avoid it. Means here we are discussing about both what is the reason and how to avoid these contaminations. So first one is the new component. Now how the due to new component contamination is increased? So during the repair and the servicing, suppose in the hydraulic system some maintenance is come, and due to we create the some repairing or a servicing, either we replace the some component. Okay, why do we need to replace the component? Because they are worn out or a damage, old components are replaced by a new component, and this new component may not be clean inside, and they contain the dust, dirt and other impurities. So they need to clean before fitting the new component. Okay, in short, when we fit the new component in a hydraulic system, we need to take care that the component is completely cleaned from insides. Okay, so inside there is a dust, dirt and other impurities are there. So we need to clean inside, then after fitting the new components in a hydraulic systems. Second point is carelessness during servicing. Maintenance people should be aware of cleanliness and its benefits. So service people are at least need to take care that the component must be cleansed, then after fit into the hydraulic systems. Third one is the surrounding. Surrounding means that is the outside atmospheres of the hydraulic system. Dirty surrounding cause the contaminations of hydraulic fluids. So surrounding must be kept clean. So outside atmosphere of the hydraulic system must be to clean. Okay, if this there is a dirt and dust in the surroundings, there is a possibility of that the dirt and dust are going inside the hydraulic systems. Next one is the wear and tear. Wear and tear cause the release of minute particles from the materials, hence the lubrication should be proper and worn out components should be replaced soon. Okay, so we earlier studied that due to the wear and tear, some particles are removed from this component, that is called as the burrs, and these burrs are added into the hydraulic systems or hydraulic oils, and they are start to the adding the contaminations in the hydraulic oil. So we need to take care that lubrication should be proper to the worn out component, either we need to replace the worn out component and fit the new component inside the hydraulic systems. Next one is the corrosions of the part. So due to the corrosion, you see that is a some materials are coming from these corrosions of the parts. Okay, so rust particles get into oil, so it is called as the rust particles. When the some metal is corroded, they are giving the small rust particles. Okay, and these rust particles are getting into the oil, hence the corrosions must be avoided. So that's reasons we need to avoid the corrosions, and if the corrosion is there, we need to remove the corrosions or either the fit the new components. Next one is the humidity in the atmosphere. Humidity in the atmosphere means in air, you know that is oxygen is there, nitrogen is there, carbon dioxide is there and some other gas. Okay, with this gas in atmosphere, the moisture is present. Okay, so amount of the moisture present in air, it is called as the humidity. Okay, that's why we feeling the humidity issue in a different seasons. Okay, so humidity is also depend on the season to seasons. Okay, so humidity in a atmospheric air, so water from the atmosphere get into the oil. So water from atmosphere means inside the air there is also moisture is there, and moisture is one type of the water. Okay, so this can be minimized to a greater extent by taking a proper care. Next one is the storage of oil. Oil should be stored in a closed container. Okay, suppose if we store the oil in a open container, then what happen? The oil is absorb the moisture from the atmosphere. Okay, so they absorb the humidity, and due to humidity the this moisture is converted into the water in some component due to different pressure and temperatures. So surrounding must be kept clean. Oils of different grades should never be mixed by mistake. Means the oil are present in a number of grades. Okay, so we not mix to the different grade of oil together then supply to the hydraulic system. We only required to use any one specific grade of the hydraulic oils in a hydraulic systems. So thank you for watching this video. If you learned and like the video, subscribe the channels and don't forget to share with your friends.